Hey there, good optometry morning. Dr. Michael Nelson, your YouTube eye doctor here, and today I'm going to talk to you about why you have that stye in your eye. And so I'm going to try to tell you how to make that eye stye go bye-bye, and the time for that is nigh. If you're watching this video right now, you have a red, swollen, tender lid, and you're wondering what it is and what you can do about it. And so chances are that's a stye, and in the next few minutes I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about styes and what you can do about it and what you shouldn't do about it. But if this is your first time watching this video, make sure you hit the subscribe and the notification bell button so you can make sure you get more videos like this one about your eyes and your vision and glasses and contact lenses. All right, so what is a stye? The medical term for a stye is hordeolum, and basically it's an infection of one of the glands of the eyelid. So there's three main glands in the eyelid. First of all, there's the meibomian gland. The meibomian gland produces a lot of the important oils for your tear film on the surface of your eye. And next there are the glands of Zeis, and the glands of Zeis are a sebaceous gland that produce some of the oils that are important for the eyelashes. And lastly, there's the glands of Moll, and the glands of Moll are basically a sweat gland for the lid. And so there's bacteria that lives on our skin. It's called our normal flora, and it's important to be there because it keeps other bacteria away and it eats some of the dead cells and oils that live on the surface of our skin. But sometimes this bacteria will get trapped in some of these glands, and that will result in a hordeolum or a stye. So what are the symptoms you're going to get if you have a stye? So if you have a stye, basically this is an infection in the gland. There's going to be some telltale signs of an infection when you have this. So they're going to include the lid's going to be red, it's going to be swollen, it's going to be tender or painful, particularly to the touch. It's going to be really feel inflamed, and the whole tissue is going to feel kind of warm. So what all these symptoms tell you is that you have an infection in the lid, and there's a good chance that that infection is a stye. All right, so I'm going to point out that sometimes you can get a really hard lump in the lid that actually isn't that tender. You can actually press on it and it's not sore and painful to the touch like a stye would be. And that's something different than a stye, and I'm going to explain what that is at the end of the video. All right, so we've narrowed this down to probably being a stye. And so what are we going to do about that? So I'm going to give you some suggestions of way we can treat this and manage this, but I think it's a really good idea that you book an appointment with your optometrist to take a look, because there's some eyelid infections which will feel like and look like a stye, which may not be. These can include dacryocystitis, which is an infection of the lacrimal duct and sac where the tears drain out. You can have a preseptal cellulitis, which is an infection of the entire lid and not just the glands. Or you can have an orbital cellulitis, which is when the eyelid infection can spread back and start to infect the whole orbit around the eyeball. And so some of these are definitely more serious, and they can be vision threatening, and some of them require oral or IV antibiotics to deal with. So make sure you call your eye doctor so they can rule out these other more serious problems. And so when you call them, just say, I've got a stye, but I'd like the optometrist to take a look and rule out some of these more serious things. All right, so steps that you can do right now that can help with your stye. So first of all, styes are generally self-limiting, meaning they're gonna get better on their own. And usually the normal healing of them is about 7 to 14 days. Your body is really good at fighting off styes, and so it's gonna send immune factors to fight off that infection and heal it up. But it's usually gonna go in a wave. Usually it gets worse for about 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 days, and then it'll reach a peak, and then it'll start to get better. So it's not unusual that I'll see a patient and they'll be like day 2 or 3 when they've had a problem, and oftentimes it might get worse for a couple of days before it starts to get better. Okay, the first thing that you can do to help deal with your stye is hot compress. You provide a lot of heat to the lid, that brings more blood supply, and with more blood supply you get more immune response, and so basically that's your body's defense system at fighting off that infection. And so steady and regular hot compresses can help in the resolution of styes a little bit faster. So the key here is steady and regular. And so what I mean by steady is that you need about 10 minutes of good heat applied to the lid, and you need that regularly, probably 2 to 4 times per day over a number of days to help in the resolution of the stye. And so what you use to provide that heat is important. A lot of people might try a washcloth in hot water, but if you've ever put that on your lid, you'll notice it cools off in probably about 10 seconds. So you're definitely not getting steady heat. And certainly there's not enough heat to help in the resolution of the stye. So what you need are products that hold heat for a long period of time. So there's a number of products that you can get. This is one of my favorites called the Bruder Mask. And basically this has a mask that you can heat this up in your microwave for probably about 10 or 20 seconds, and then you can apply this right onto your lids, and that's gonna hold a lot of heat onto the lids for at least 10 minutes. So you can often find this product or something like it at your optometrist's office, but I'm gonna put a link for it down below where you can look for it as well. One thing that I always make sure I remind my patients when they are using these hot compresses is that bringing more blood supply, and when you get more blood supply, you're gonna get more swelling and more redness. So it's not unusual when you're doing these treatments, it's gonna make your stye and your lid look and perhaps feel even a little bit worse, but that's the intended effect that you want. But that increased blood supply and swelling are bringing healing effects to that stye. So another treatment that we will use when you have an eye infection are antibiotics. So when you have a bacterial infection, antibiotics can be really effective in bringing down and quietening down and helping your immune system fight off that infection. So there is some question about whether antibiotic eye drops or antibiotic ointments that you apply to the surface of your lid or your eye are effective in treating styes. The general thought by eye doctors is that these antibiotics really don't penetrate through the lid well enough to help fight off that infection. But sometimes we will prescribe them and maybe they give some effect, and if that infection is close to the surface, maybe you get a little bit of effect from those antibiotics. Usually to get effective antibiotic effects on a stye, you need oral antibiotics, which are pills. And sometimes we'll prescribe that if styes are bad enough or chronic enough, but sometimes it's a little bit overkill for some minor styes that just heal up on their own anyway. But that's a conversation you'll wanna have with your eye doctor, whether it's beneficial to use oral antibiotics or not. All right, so another thing that you can do in the treatment, and probably more importantly in the prevention of developing styes, is lid hygiene. So all of us wash our hair and our body with soap every single day, but most of us don't wash our eyes and our eyelashes with any soapy-like products because they tend to sting the eyes. But if you tend to have a higher count of the normal flora and the normal bacteria around on your lashes, in order to reduce those numbers and to keep them clean, you do need some type of surfactant which will reduce the number of bacteria and the waste products that those bacteria produce. And there are a number of eyelid cleaning products on the market that can be really beneficial. I'll give you a few examples of the ones I really like. So you can get products like this one, which is a foam, and you pump a little bit of the foam onto your fingers and you can just scrub around your lids and your lashes to help clean the surface. You can also get products like this one. This is called Systane Lid Wipes. These are all available over the counter. I'll put some links for them as well. And this is a little lid wipe that has a soapy-like solution that doesn't sting your eyes, and you just open up the product and you can rub and clean on your lids. This is another product that I really, really like. This is probably my favorite, called Blephaclean. This is available over the counter, but you won't find it in any drugstores. You'll only find it at your eye clinics or online. Again, I'll put a link below. All right, and so how do you use these products? So this is Blephaclean, and I'm going to give you a little demonstration as how I would use this product. And so basically it comes in a little pouch, and you open this up, and when you open it up, it's going to have a little towelette inside, and basically you're just going to unfold this towelette, and then what you can do is close your eye, and then you take that towelette and you give it a good rub around on your lids and your lashes, and then you're going to flip that over to the other side, and then you can scrub and wash the lids and the lashes of the other eye. And I really like the Blephaclean because it feels soothing to the surface of your eye and it leaves no residue, and so you can just leave it on. You don't have to feel like you have to wipe it off. So these lid wipes and lid hygiene products can reduce the number of bacteria that are on the surface of your eye to reduce the frequency of styes if you have them on a frequent basis. They also have a little bit of benefit in treating a stye so that you don't have additional bacteria on the surface, and they can also help clean off any of the pus or any of the mucus that's developing from a stye. Okay, so what things should you not do if you have a stye? So number one, it is recommended you don't wear makeup. There's a couple of reasons for this. Number one, makeup is a great medium for growing bacteria. So if you're applying makeup and you have an infection on your lid, some of that bacteria can get into the makeup and then contaminate your good makeup that you had. The other thing is that the makeup that you have could be the source of the infection. So if your makeup is infected with bacteria, sometimes applying that makeup could be feeding that infection and making it a little bit worse. So it's generally advised not to wear makeup when you have a stye. Number two, should you wear contact lenses when you have a stye? Again, it is recommended that you don't wear contact lenses when you have an infection around on the surface or in the lid of your eye. When you wear contact lenses normally, you are putting yourself at a little bit higher risk for infections anyways. And if you already have an active infection and your body's trying to fight off, it puts you at even higher risk for developing infections on the surface of the cornea or on the surface of the conjunctiva. So it's recommended you don't wear contact lenses when you have a STYE. Okay, and number three, the third thing you definitely don't want to do when you have a STYE is try to pop it or press it or express that STYE. The reason for this is if you squeeze that STYE, sometimes you can push that infection and that bacteria deeper into the tissues, and you can develop a more serious eyelid infection that can spread to the entire lid or behind the lid or into the orbit, which can be very, very serious. And those may require oral or IV antibiotics to prevent vision loss and serious eye problems. If you're using a hot compress, it might cause the infection to come to head and express itself just naturally, and that's okay, but you don't want to squeeze it to try to force the expression of that infection. All right, so earlier I talked about situations where you can develop a lump in the lid where it's kind of swollen and you have this hard nodule or lump in the lid, but it's actually not tender to the touch. And this may be what we call a chalazion. And so basically a chalazion is a cyst where one of those glands is packed with mucus or debris or particles, often remnants of a STYE where the body has fought off the infection and now you have all the debris remaining from that infection that's trapped in that gland and hasn't been removed. And so in those cases, you'll have this hard little nodule and you'll feel like a little grain of rice or a little small little pea that you can feel and you can move it around, but it's not actually tender to the touch. So the fact that it's not painful and tender and red like a STYE is a good sign that there's not an infection there, but that gland is just packed with this material. So what do you do for a chalazion? So a chalazion you can continue to treat with the hot compresses, and slowly the body and the blood supply will break up that chalazion and remove it and it will go down, but that can take a number of months. Occasionally when it's there for a long period of time or chronic, then you can see an ophthalmologist and they can do a small surgery where they cut open that gland and express the contents and get rid of it completely. But if you think you have a chalazion, then check with your optometrist as well and they can confirm that diagnosis as well. All right, if you have any other questions about STYEs or eyelid infections, leave a comment below and make sure you hit the subscribe and the bell button to get more videos just like this one. And with that, have a great optometry day.